Good morning. It's time for that month in this month in real estate. I've done a something special today where I've also there's a new HTML long version of the newsletter which I've made the elements for, and I'm going to show you how to use. First of all, we're going to do what the old school one was, which involves simply using an email or a postcard template. So what we're going to do is start by clicking on My Marketing, go to Create Marketing Materials, and we're going to wait. And wait and wait and wait. Great. And most people are using it for email, so we're going to click on Email Marketing. And we're not doing the HTML optimized. By clicking on image base, it'll just make it easier to find the right one. We're going to type in the word month and hit enter. And it shows us that this month's in real estate. And what we're looking for is August 2015, which is this one. And so it starts with the national number. So you're going to click on personalize. And what I've done, there'll be a link to a folder which has all of the pictures and elements. What we're going to do is we're going to go over here to where it says image, and then we're going to click on upload image, select file, and then you need to know, well, where your image is. And it's going to be in a folder that looks very much like this. And we want to pick the email version. There's a postcard version and an email version. I was trying something new. Let's see how it works. And then we close it. And then just basically you put this up in the corner and you drag that down. And what you've done is you've created, and I could see just a little bit over here. So let's just move it over and then move it over. And then, so now we've created, this is the updated image. You don't have to go through all the trouble of, you know, making all the changes and that sort of thing. It's got your branding on it. So we're going to click on save. And I've already done this once. So that's, I'm just going to say second. Click on save. And OK. And then exit after you've saved it. And now it's going to give you a chance to compose email. So you click on compose email. You would type in something like this month in real estate, August 2015. And you click on the two, and you could then include everybody that you've got an email for and add them all. And when you do that, you would just hit save and continue, and it would send them out. Right. So that's the old, that's the standard system. What I'd like to do is I've also provided the elements for the new HTML version. I'll show you how that works. So we're going to start on My Marketing, create marketing materials, and then let it go around. The HTML version will look better. It won't have that fuzzy look. It won't be a picture or as much of just one big picture. And so what we're going to do is we're going to go to email marketing. The long HTML version is only available in email. If we just leave it so where it says HTML and type in month and hit enter, here they are. And we're looking for this month in real estate for August 2015. So this is what it looks like. Ew. And so what we're going to do is click on personalize. And one of the things that I've provided, let me make sure where it is. Oh, this is what I've provided, is the words that are needed for each of the sections. So the first section, we're going to just copy that first paragraph. And then when we go back here, for updating it, we would say this month in real estate. Oops. Now, notice how it's turned black. So if we go over to where the cursor is right next to the E, maybe you could see that the cursor is now blinking red. Now when we move forward and do this, it's still in red. Now we could go and change the font color, but I'm too lazy to do efficient to do that. Santa Clara County Edition. And I like to make it clear that this is Santa Clara County. So we highlight that, we go to font size, and let's make it 16. All right, we're very proud. This month in real estate is a National Association of Realtors information. National information doesn't work very well. And if we click on cut, it'll go away. By the way, sometimes when you click on the cut, it won't go away depending on the browser you're using. But if you do Control X, it'll go away, or Command X if you're a Mac person. So we take the first paragraph of text and copy that, and we replace this first paragraph of text with the text that I've written, because our information is different. We leave the interest rates alone. Home sales, this is national information, so we want to get rid of that. And then we're going to replace it with our own picture. And so if we click on Insert Image, and we go over here to Upload Image and to select Files, and one of the images I've provided is about home sales. I hope I've done the right one. Click on, did I do the right one? We'll know in a second. And close, and yes. And so this is the home sales for Santa Clara County. And what you're going to notice, see how it redraws itself and putting the text underneath. And so that's pretty easy to read. The text needs to be changed, but I've thought of that too. So you copy paragraph number 2 and you, put that in. And we've changed the text. Home prices, we click on that. And again, if Control X or Command X, if it's not deleting, we now, so we delete that picture. We go up to Insert Image. We upload an image. We select the files. We take image number 2, upload it, cancel. And it should be looking here, but I don't see it. Interesting. Control X. Let's try that one more time. Upload image, select file, click on that. Maybe I'm just doing it too fast. Upload, waiting. All right. Close. There we go. And then again, we make it big, and now we have a great big image. It looks beautiful. We have to replace the text, so this would be paragraph number 3. Copy. Paste. And the last one is inventory. I'm going to change that, but what we're really going to do is Control Z. So again, I want to make it what I'm doing here is I want to make sure I'm editing this text here, because I don't want to have to retype it. And so if I start typing off to the side, it's going to change the font and all that. So this is list to sale price and days to sell. And then if we notice, it's right in the middle, which the other ones weren't. We click on text alignment and it goes over there. That may take a little bit of practice. Make sure these all look pretty much the same. This one's a little bit over. So what I'm going to do is, I didn't realize this was going to cause trouble. Add a couple of bumps to it. And that looks close enough, maybe one more. One thing that we could do that would make this easier is we could make all of them in the center, but I can see that, anyhow, good enough for government work. We click on this, we get rid of it, and then we're going to add our image, and our image is a lot cooler than theirs, and we select the file, and that's this image here. We upload it, And I guess I was just not waiting. And then we make it bigger. And 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 what this is that it shows days to sell average and sale to list price ratio. And that's the last text here. Copy. And we replace. And there we go. And so now we've got this beautiful HTML newsletter. And now that we're done with all that, we click on save and SCC. Save it. And wait. There we go. Okay. Exit. Compose email. This is sort of showing you what it looks like. Isn't that just gorgeous? And you click on compose email and send it out just like you did before. Anyhow, that's how it works. I'm going to include not only a link to this video, but a link to where all of these goodies are. And if you have any questions, give me a call. That's it.